I would like to thank everyone for coming out this afternoon. My name is Mrs. Russ. I'm the principal of this wonderful elementary school. We would like to welcome you to our groundbreaking ceremony for our wonderful reading garden. We would like to thank Mr. Paris. He is our safety patrol sponsor for organizing our safety patrols, and they will begin our program with presenting our colors.
Color guard, attention! Color guard, forward march!
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Color guard, post the flag of the great state of Florida.
This is such a momentous occasion for us that we wanted to honor it and give it its just deserves. So we have just a small program that we have put together to break the ground on such a garden that is going to, I believe, nourish our boys and girls and encourage them to continue to be readers. Ramona has had its share of disappointments, and we are on our rise, and our boys and girls, if you can look in their faces, they have done such a tremendous job in their own achievements, and this garden will be the one that just puts the stamp on all of the hard work they have done thus far. So welcome to Ramona Blvd Elementary, and welcome to our ceremony. We are going to do some introductions so you will know who we are. You already know who I am. And then we are going to start with our front row. To my left, we're going to start with the Honorable Mrs. Constance Hall. And we're going to continue with our school board chairman. He's here in two capacities, one as a Rotary member and the other as our school board chair. No, our not anymore. Our school board member, the Honorable Fel Lee. We're going to continue with Miss Dr. Coker Daniel. She is our regional chief. She's been the one, our cheerleader of all of our hard work. We have Mrs. Kelly Kinney, our assistant principal. We have Mrs. Rigdon, who by title is our secretary bookkeeper, but so much more here at, I want to say, my right hand here at Ramona. Then we're going to continue to the second row. We have Mr. Norm Washer, our architect of Washer, right? Washer and Rotarian. And then to continuing, we have Mr. Doug Register, also a Rotarian with us. Then if we go to the right, we have the parents of Mrs. Rigdon that is joining us here today with us this afternoon. Continuing to our next row, we have Mr. Pat Mulvihill, a Rotarian with us, working the camera and doing an awesome job, is also a Rotarian, and his name is Mr. John. What is it? Markeret. I'm sorry, I wrote down John. We have our wonderful contractors in the back, right, that are waiting to pour the concrete in our ground. So we're excited about that. We have Mr. Paris, who is our fifth grade patrol sponsor and math teacher. We have Mrs. Omer and Mrs. Klein, our fifth grade reading teachers. And to our right, we have Mr. Dion, our fifth grade science teacher. And please give a round of applause for my boys and girls, all of our fifth graders that are out here today. Let's give them a round of applause for their hard work. So we thank you for coming out this morning and without further ado, we're going to turn it over to Mr. Pat Mulville Hill.
How many from here were over at the zoo to see us about a month ago? Come on up here with me.
This is just the fifth grade.
I know it's just the fifth grade. The presentation I saw there was magnificent. Congratulations. What we saw were young men and women that will become leaders in the future, coming from their head, minds, their heart, and also as far as there were fire in the belly. Now, I understand on the belly side, one of the comments that came out was they'd love to be Rotarians. We business people, we meet at the zoo, we take Friday afternoons off, we play with the animals, and we eat macaroni and cheese. Was that your assessment, that we have mac and cheese and it was good?
It was very good.
Yeah. The microphone system we had there was a little too tall for the first, second, third, fourth grade, so of course we had boxes. But the presentation was first class. In fact, probably better than most of the Rotarians make. They knew their subject matter. They were able to go ahead and properly articulate as far as their ideas, their design. This is a collaboration between Rotarians and also the teachers, the staff, the faculty, and also the primary of the students. The students are the leaders in this. This is your garden, your ideas, your design. We're only instruments trying to go ahead and put it all together with you. And the learning aspects here for having it as a learning garden, as a reading garden, and also then getting into health, getting into other science, getting into a little bit of technology, a lot of weather, a lot of bugs and insects. What was the animal that we saw that day at the zoo?
I think it was a blue-tongued skink. That's what it was.
This particular skink came from Australia. It was about 3 feet long. Its tongue was about wasn't it about a foot long? And the children, of course, loved petting this reptile. Our female Rotarians, I don't know if you were noticing this, they all ran out the back door when they saw you petting.
Disgusting.
let me give you a little background as far as in Rotary, and thank you very much. We're a group of businessmen and women. We're members of a global organization. We have 1.2 members worldwide. We're in about 34,000 clubs, but the clubs are in the communities. We work in our community, your community, whether it's here in Jacksonville or whether it's somewhere else in the state or out of the country. In fact, we have projects that are ongoing in Dominican Republic and down in the Central American region, and we've been working for years down in Haiti. So there's a lot of ongoing projects which are continuous, as well as over into India. I don't know if you're aware of this, but Rotary is responsible for almost eliminating completely around the world the scourge that was a disease affecting 40, 50 years ago young men and women in their prime as they were growing up, polio. And we're at the level right now, we have about 2 billion immunizations that have been administered through polio programs from Rotarians around the world, and I think at this point it's a little over $900 million that has gone into the project. And of course this is all fostered through Rotarians and also from their local communities, and there's a lot of assistance with collaboration coming out of foundations such as Bill Gates and also with Warren Buffett. When we get down to our district here, our new district governor elect in the district year for 15-16 is Phil Lee, and Phil is going to be leading 3,100 Rotarians we're in 12 counties in North Florida, and we're operating in about 30 different communities, and we have 59 clubs. We're doing a lot of work in education. We do a lot of work in health. In the education, we're in all of the major colleges. We're doing some work, advisory work, over with the folks at the University of North Florida. We've been working with Jacksonville University and also with FSCJ. And in the high schools, we've been very involved as far as our little club, and there's only 30 of us. We've been working up at First Coast High School. But our proudest project right now is right here. This is it. This is the center as far as of the community, and there's going to be a lot of good coming out of this. Doug, why don't you come up here? And Norm? This is not my project. This is Norm and Doug's. Started this project many, many months ago. Norm is a renowned architect doing projects around the world. Doug has been doing projects around the Southeast and a lot of projects here in Jacksonville. Doug, do you want to say a few words here?
Sure, I will. I'm happy to be here. First, I want to echo Pat's remarks. Grayson, you guys did a great job, and proud that y'all came over and did the job you did. It was great. And I want to thank y'all for allowing us to be involved in the project. I'm a general contractor, so I'm wearing two hats. I'm a Rotarian, and we, as Rotarians, we do service. We come together in fun and fellowship to do service in the community, and as Pat said, internationally as well. But one thing we do is we collaborate. You guys know what collaborate means, anybody? Collaborate. You talk with others about ideas, exactly. We come together, and there are a lot of people collaborating. We got together here because we worked on a gazebo over at Alden Road. Norm designed that. Norm redesigned the gazebo here. And from that, we work with the school board, who have been very good to work with us, especially on a volunteer basis. That's one group that is here today, but they've worked very closely with us. We've got I'm a contractor, and I work with my contractors. Two of them are in the back. They came out here last Saturday with Pat and Miss Rigdon and pulled the concrete and the dirt and the grass out of here. And then you might have seen us here the other day, and we, you know, we're taking the rest of the materials off. We're going to, as soon as we finish today, we're going to start laying out the area that we're going to form up and pour back here. So we're going to do that and dig some footings and put the steel in. But it's a great collaboration. It's a collaboration between our tradesmen and contractors that are here volunteering to help us out, Norm volunteering to draw the plans, contractors, Pat to help lead the project, and your teachers. So we want you to know that it takes all of us to come together to do this, and we are happy to do that. We're going to be working throughout, and as Pat said, we're looking forward to constructing and completing the gazebo, and I hope after that you'll invite us to continue working with us, and we'd like to invite you to do the same. So thank you very much.
The next person that's going to come up and talk, as being my right hand, but she's so much more, she's going to talk to you about how the project originated, where it started, and how it got to this point. We're very excited about just one idea blossoming in such a beautiful one. So please put your hands together and welcome to the podium, Miss Rigdon.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Kim Rigdon, and I'm the secretary bookkeeper here at the school. But you might say I kind of put my hand in all kinds of things. But this is my baby, and I'm very proud of it. I began working for DCPS in Ramona Elementary just a little over 2 years ago. And shortly after I started, Mr. Paris came to me and said he had submitted a grant to Lowe's and that they had accepted it, and they had sent us a check. And so he hands me this check, and we weren't really sure what we were doing at that point, but we deposited it and started, you know, talking. And he shared his desire to build a central structure that we could have a reading garden around. And his site was to hold our classes here, allow us to do grade level. We do other things in the summer. And that was, you know, so the fifth grade and I came out. We used their bodies to set it out and show what how big it would be, and they decided that maybe we were being a little too extravagant. So we changed and went to just one gazebo, and that's where it all started. And so I started calling people. The people at DCPS was wonderful. Chris Eskelin then transferred me over and gave me Doug Register's name. And then we went on and met Norm and Pat, and we've just met so many people that have been so wonderful to us. In addition to working on this gazebo, I started thinking we're going to have this wonderful gazebo out here and grass. So we started thinking about how we could change it. And because it was the fifth grade that started it, we decided we'd start with maybe trying to do something for the fifth grade. We decided we would do a culinary garden for them. So as you can see to the right, we've started building 360-foot beds where each student should be able to have a 3-foot by 4-foot plot that they can grow their vegetables and so forth in. And in that, it will tie into their science, their reading, their mathematics, everything. And we're really able to do that part of this is because we obtained a grant from the Florida Agriculture Classroom in the classroom program. And so we started it about a month ago, and we hope to plant next month. So we should see some good tasting stuff here pretty soon. But I'd like to thank you for being here to share in this event. And I hope to see everyone again at the end of the year when we do the dedication. And we'll have the whole school out, and it'll be a really wonderful event. And we have a couple students that want to share their insight and their vision. Lexine?
My name is Lexine Gray, and I'm a fifth grader at Ramona Elementary. I have a little sister who was a kindergartner last year, and she is in the first grade this year. I'm really glad the school is working on such a great place for all the students. Kindergartners will be excited to be in their whimsy and wonderment garden, where bowling balls become bugs and plastic bottles and soda cans become beautiful flowers. The first graders have the opportunity to use their imagination and creativity in their fantasies and fairy's garden. The little fairy houses will be so cute, and all of the first graders will love pretending fairies live at Ramona. I can remember when I was in second grade and we raised butterflies from cocoons. We were so excited to watch the butterfly come out of its shell. It is great that everyone can experience that in the birds and butterfly garden. The gazebo will benefit all of the students at Ramona. It is a great place to have our spring reading picnic, and on Fridays when we've done all of our work, it could be used for fun Friday activities.
And so many of us know our wonderful Grayson. He's going to present for the third, fourth, and fifth grade.
Good afternoon. My name is Grayson Whitehurst, and I'm a fifth grader at Ramona Elementary. I wish as a third grader I had been able to go to a place like the Sensory and Tranquility Garden. It would have helped me with the stress of the FCAT started to weigh heavily on me. The fourth graders are going to be so lucky. Their garden is designed to help them with their writing. I think the words on the rocks are a great idea and will help everyone learn to write better. The fifth graders will have a culinary garden this year. I think it will give us a lot of experience. We can learn to plant seeds and grow our own vegetables and fruits. I am excited to think that I can go outside and pick some lettuce, tomatoes, and onions, and other vegetables to make a salad or other things to eat. Then I won't have to go to the grocery store to get my produce. I help build the plant beds and learn how to use a power screwdriver, and that exact measurement is important so the boards will fit together properly. The whole time we were working, we talked about what kinds of things we would like to grow. The gazebo gives us a chance to go outside with our class on beautiful days. There are so many things we can do with it. We can have our Book of the Month celebration there, or teachers can have class in it. When we even have an entire grade level use it, so everyone can be together for a lesson. There are so many possibilities for how we can use a gazebo. It's going to be a fabulous addition to Ramona.
That was just a little snippet of the talent that we have right here at Ramona Elementary. We are so excited about the work our boys and girls have done. Continuing in our program, we're going to have our assistant principal, Mrs. Kinney, and she's going to share with you our school vision.
You guys know every day when we come to Ramona that we're working to build that solid foundation. That's what we're doing, right? Building a community of learners. And so each day when you come, we're working to make sure you're ready in reading and you're ready in math and science and writing. And when I was thinking about this today, I thought, man, we have some more foundation here. We have an art foundation this year and a music foundation, and we have a great physical education with Coach, don't we? He does a great job. So then I was thinking about how is this garden going to fit in to make you guys fulfill the vision of Ramona Eagles? And I thought, when that gazebo is behind us and it's there, you're going to be able to come and bring all of the learning that you do in your classroom from kindergarten all the way up to where you are right now in fifth grade and really show yourselves and your parents and your community and your teachers what a phenomenal student we're going to be sending out into the community for middle school and high school. And so I know that the work that you've been doing is hard work, but it's important and just as important as the work that we do each day when we build that foundation in reading, writing, math, and science. So congratulations, Mr. Paris, congratulations, Ms. Rigdon, and Ms. Russ, because at Ramona, we really are building a foundation with a community of learners. Way to go, guys.
All right, for the moment we've all been waiting for, it's time to break ground. We have just a couple. If you look behind us, boys and girls, you see the shovels with the hard hats. And we have some people that are going to put on a hard hat today for a photo op and grab a shovel to break ground with us. So, all right, boys and girls, let's give our honorable guests another round of applause. We are always, always excited to show off the great work that we're doing here at Ramona. We are never defined as to what our school grade tell us we are. We always look at the children within our building. We set high expectations, and every year our boys and girls have rose to that expectation. We are so excited. It started with a vision, and this year we said we were going to build a community of learners. That is our theme this year, and it has resonated through the entire school year. We're excited about all of the things that you are doing, boys and girls. We are bragging on you each and every day. So please don't rush out of Ramona Boulevard today. We want to show off to you the reading that's happening already in our classrooms. We want to show off to you the artwork that they have worked on thus far. We have our first annual art walk this evening. We want to give a special thank you to the Rotary. They're doing much more than just our reading garden. They are sponsoring a spaghetti dinner tonight for our boys and girls to raise funds to complete our garden and to support our vision. So we are very excited about this new partnership. We want to thank you thus far for your work and the work that we're going to do together in the future. We have prepared just a small, some refreshments for you all in one of our classrooms. It is always important to me, and I say to my teachers and I say to my administration, where is the center of our work? It is always with our students. So it's very important for me to show off the work that our boys and girls. So our refreshments will not be tucked away in the front office. They are actually in our fifth grade science room. So you can take a closer look at the work we're doing with the garden and the work we're doing in our classrooms. And our boys and girls are going to go and continue with their extended reading hour. and do that work that they've been doing. We're so excited about that. And so if you can follow me, and boys and girls, let's give yourselves and our guests another round of applause and thank them for coming out today. And if you can join us, all of our guests, in our science lab that is right behind us, science classroom. All right.